You might have so much stuff in this backpack. So heavy. I know if I can keep going. We should just get rid of this thing. Won't come off. So much stuff. Just leave it somewhere. Gotta keep going.
You'll have purpose, direction, and guess what, brother? You'll have hope. Just follow me.
Purpose, direction, and hope.
Yes, sir.
All right. Follow you.
Follow me. Ready?
Ready.
Go. Friend, where are you going?
Oh, well, I really have to go over here first. I have people. I have things I gotta take care of over here.
It only works if you follow me.
Follow you.
Follow me. It doesn't work if you go your own way. Let me tell you, brother, I know that way looks good, but it ends in a bad way. This way ends in a great way, and you'll be free. I guarantee you, if you go down that road again, you'll pick up another backpack. You'll pick up more stuff. You'll be weighed down. You'll end up right where you were before.
Don't want more stuff.
Then follow me. This is how it works.
Okay.
You ready now?
Yes.
Not your way.
Not my way.
My way.
Your way. Okay. I'm ready.
You're ready.
Yes.
Purpose. Direction.
Purpose. Direction. Hope.
Hope.
Freedom.
Freedom. Freedom, brother. You ready?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Here we go.
Okay.
One step at a time. Just watch me. You keep in step with me. There you go. You're doing good. Look at you. You're doing great. See how easy it is when you follow me? And you keep in step with me? What are you doing, friend?
Yeah.
What are you doing? What are you doing?
Well, this is part of my stuff that I'm really missing. I love this stuff.
I know. But look how it's weighing you down.
It is kind of heavy.
It's weighing you down. That's why you gave it to me in the first place. Remember, you did so good when you cast your cares on me. Don't take it back, brother. Let me help you. You can't carry it, brother. It's going to weigh you down. It's taking away your hope. You've got to cast it on me and leave it on me. Let me help you. Let me help you. That's good. That's good. Put it back on me. Put it back on me. Not on you. On me. That's good. That's good. You're doing good. Now.
Okay.
You better?
Yes. Much. Much better.
Praise the Lord.
Better.
You're good.
Okay.
Now, the lesson is, once you cast your cares on me, leave them on me. Don't take them back.
Leave them on me.
There you go. Are you ready to go again?
Yes.
Okay, follow me. Keep in step with me. Now listen, we're getting ready for a rough spot here.
Okay.
This is especially the time where you want to stay close to me.
Okay.
Stay close and step with me. I take a step, you take a step. Because this is a really rough part. And above all, don't reach back and take any of that stuff back that you... Friend.
But I want this so much.
Don't pick it back up, especially during this rough time. It's not only going to weigh you down, you're going to fall. Do you want to fall?
No.
No, you want to stand. Come on, let me help you. Stand. Use my strength and let me help you stand. Now put it back on me. Put it back on me. You can do it. You can do it. There you go.
Okay.
Now, leave it on me. Stay close to me. Dangerous area.
Purpose.
This is a really rough spot.
Direction.
Yeah, follow me. Each step, just like my step.
Hope.
You're doing it.
Hope.
You're doing it.
Okay.
Now we're here. Now we're through. Now we're through. Hey, how about
I
it?
I like this. I
it
like
feels
this.
Good now, doesn't
yes.
It?
Yes, it feels wonderful.
All right.
It feels really good.
All right. Now, just stay away and don't pick that stuff up again. I'll carry it for you. Are you with me?
Yes, yes, yes. I'm with you.
Let's go.
Okay.
All right.
Following you.
Follow me. Don't grab that stuff anymore.
I won't. No more. I won't.
You're doing good.
Following you.
You're free.
Amen.
Walk me through the process. Tell me about the guy coming out here.
All his problems.
All his problems, okay. You ever been there, guys?
Yeah.
That's what it feels like, doesn't it? He says, we carry a heavy burden, doesn't he? Did you notice he had to come to a place where he stopped? Is that correct? I want to tell you a story. A friend of mine told me this. He said, Sammy said, I was sitting at home one night. He said, guess what? He said, I was depressed, discouraged, defeated. He said, I had no strength, couldn't go on for another moment. He said, I got out of bed, went out to my chair, and sat down and looked up and said, Lord, I've had enough of this, it's all yours. He said, the voice of the Lord said this. He said, good, that's all I've been waiting for. Now I'm ready to lay it down. He said, with that, he said, I went back to bed and slept comfortably every night thereafter. I want to read to you a passage of scripture, if I might. It's out of 1 Peter chapter 5. Listen to me, please. It says, number one, in verse 6, humble yourselves, therefore, under God's mighty hand. I want to pause there for this reason. First thing we have to do as we carry out the burden is this. Come to the place where we realize we need God's mighty hand to carry it for us. Amen? Sometimes people feel like they're defeated because, after all, I am a Christian. I should be able to do this. Beloved, listen to me, please. We need God's mighty hand to carry it for us. Amen? Then notice this, then it says after that, after we come to that realization, it says, then we cast our cares upon him. That word care is very interesting because it means anxieties, worries, fears, doubts, frustrations. We bring all that to him and we say, God, I can't do this, but you can, and I want to give it to you. Amen? Are you there today? Are you carrying something? Anybody carrying anything today? Okay, God gave you a little notepad to write it on. Here's what I want you to do.
Hand right where you're seated right now, write out your word right there. God gave you a little stick pen to use. Write it out on your hand. Got it? Got it? Okay, now stand before Almighty God. Stand up, please. I want you to pray this prayer. Lord, you are mighty, I am not.
Lord, you are mighty, I am not.
I've been carrying this burden so long. I'm tired. I can't go another mile. But you can. So Lord, now, as an act of my will, I present this to you. Okay, now dear folks, look here. Take your hand, give it to God. Lift it right up to God. Okay? Thank you, Jesus, for taking this burden. I give it to you. It is now yours. When the enemy tries to remind me of it, I will remind him I've given it to you. I back away from it now. It is all yours. You are the mighty God. You are the everlasting Father. You are the Prince of Peace. You spoke and the worlds came into being.
You spoke and the worlds came into being.
This issue is not too big for you. I give it to you now. And I seal it in Jesus' name. Amen. Now watch this. There's one other important thing this gentleman can do with that burden. Because I can guarantee you, when you give a burden and worry to the Lord, guess what the devil's going to do? He's going to come back and try to bring it right back to you and say, here you go, Chris, it's all yours. Watch this. What is today's date, anybody? July 7th? What time is it? Don't just say, I think. What is the time? Now take your hand, write on it, July 7th, 11:35. Watch why that's important. When this gentleman came back over here, remember, came running over his feet, he was dancing? Amen? What's going to happen a week from now when he stops dancing? He's going to have that burning back there, isn't he? Unless he can do this. What if he goes back and he says, you know what, on July 7th, 11:35, right there in the middle of that platform, I gave it to Jesus Christ. Amen? Where's my friend Jesse? Jesse, I need Revelation chapter 12, verses 10 through 12. I want to show you how powerful your testimony is, beloved. But watch this. You wrote on your hand, you gave it to the Lord July 7th, 11:35. Is that correct?
Correct.
Now seal it up. Take your right hand. Your right hand is filled with the blood of Jesus Christ. Put it over your seat. who's been sealed out with the blood of Jesus Christ. Let me show you why that's very important. Revelation 12, 10 through 12, yes. Real loud.
And I heard a loud voice from heaven say, now have come the salvation, the power, and the kingdom of our God, and the authority of his side. For the accuser of our brothers and sisters, who accuses them before our God day and night, has been hurled down. They tried to deliver him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. They did not love their lives so much as to shrink from death. Therefore rejoice, you heavens, and you who dwell in them. But woe to the earth and the sea, because the devil has gone down to you. He is filled with fury, because he knows that his time is short.
Okay, thanks, Jesse. What was in your right hand?
The
blood of Jesus Christ, right? What was in your left hand?
The
word of your testimony. What two great weapons does John give us in Revelation 12? The blood of the Lamb and the word of your testimony. Now bring those together. See, now Satan cannot pull that apart. Amen? That's why it's important, guys, that you put down that July 7th, 1135. When people come to me for counseling, I always have them write it out, sign a contract with Jesus, seal it up, then they're not allowed to open it anymore, ever. Amen? Remember, 1 Peter 5, verse 6, it says, humble yourselves under the mighty hand of God. Then it says, then cast your care. Come to the end of yourself, just like the man did up here. I can't do it anymore. Jesus said, you know what? That's all I've been waiting for. Give it to me now. It's a complete deal. Amen? Now, just a few moments, you're going to hold what was represented above, the blood of Jesus Christ in your hand, in this cup right here. I want you to purposely hold it in your right hand, okay? Because your right hand today represents the blood of Jesus Christ. Remember, please, the two great weapons, the blood of Christ and your testimony. Today you brought them both together. Jesus said, come, now notice the invitation. I want all of you who are weary and heavy laden, come unto me. He said, I'm going to tell you to go take care of it. You know what he said? Now I will give you rest. Because your head burden is heavy, but my grace, my love, is kind, and it will carry you through. Amen?
Amen.
So, beloved, that which you carry today, you gave to Jesus Christ, and now that you. Amen?
Amen?
I believe God will work in your situation because you gave it to him in faith, sealed with the blood of Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen.
Elders, we come, we might serve this communion table today.
Bill Brown, would you please?
Would you join together? I've asked Pastor Jeff to lead us in prayer for the bread, symbolic of the broken body of Jesus Christ. Pastor Jeff, please.
Good Heavenly Father, Lord, we give you praise and thank you that you gave your Son, that his body was broken for us. Lord, as we partake of the symbolic gesture of Christ's body, remind us in the power. Thank you.
just for you. It's interesting because the rest of chapter 3, or chapter 5, verse 7 says this, because he cares for you. You realize that Christ is carrying your burden today, beloved, because he cares for you. Amen?
Amen.
Take your wafer, please, hold it to heaven. Lord Jesus, thank you for dying for me. Thank you for doing that which I could not do for myself, paying the penalty for my sin. You did it because you love me. You did it because you care for me. You did it because along this journey of life, you want to carry my heavy burdens just for me. And I receive this wafer with love, with kindness, and with thanksgiving. And I do so, Jesus, in remembrance of you. Amen. Let's partake together. Thank you.
tell me, please, what's in your right hand?
Blood of Jesus.
What's in your left hand?
Testimony.
Your care that's against Jesus' sake, correct? What's overshadowing your cares? The blood of Jesus Christ. What are the two powerful weapons God gave to you? The blood of the Lamb and the word of your testimony. So when Satan gets after you this week, you go right back to this spot, July 7th, 11:35 a.m. Is that correct? All the people said. Amen. Ready to wait upon you now for the benevolent offering? Gentlemen, if you would please come. The benevolent offering, beloved, is used to help those who stand in need inside of our fellowship, but also at times those who are outside of our fellowship. So we appreciate so much as you donate to this. Ask God to multiply these for His glory. Amen. Brother Larry, would you pray for this offering? One last thing I want you to do today before you go. Stand up, please, and shake your burden off. You no longer carry it. Look how free you are. Feel how free your hands are as you give this to Jesus. Amen. What about Simon? Who will pray for Simon? See what a humble guy is to forget himself? No, listen please. These kids are about to enter spiritual warfare because as much as God wants to touch them, the devil wants to keep them away from them. Amen? So lift their name to the Lord every single day.
Investing in the youth, and thank you for everything that you are doing in our midst. Lord, I pray that you always make this church a light for our neighborhood, for our city, for the state, and for the whole country and the whole world. Lord, we thank you for everything that you're investing in and the power that you're putting in us, Lord, so that we can be a light that shines in this place. In Jesus' name we come to you and thank you, Lord, for every, Lord, person that's in here, for every person you gave for us to go to life forever. Thank you for the youth who are committed also to follow you. Thank you for the love for you. Thank you for bringing them and capturing them in your love and in this beautiful church. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Go in peace and blessings to you this week. Remember your assignment to pray for one of the young people.